All right, I've had it for about a month, and it's time for me to review the Pauly Mega System. I have been playing a lot of classic games on this machine. Just a recap, the Pauly Mega is a modular system. The base unit, which is what I have right here, allows you to play Sega Saturn games, which is why I'm propped up in front of my Sega Saturn collection, Sega CD games, PlayStation 1 games, Neo Geo CD games, and TurboGrafx CD games. And I've been able to test out a lot of stuff on this machine. You've seen me stream some classic games with the Pauly Mega. You have seen my initial thoughts on the machine. You saw me unbox it. But what is it like to kind of live with this console? First of all, I love this machine. All right, so spoiler alert, I'm going to give this machine a great score at the end. But I also have to say that this is kind of the beginning of my reviews and my estimation of this console that will probably evolve over time. I've asked the PlayMagic people, the people behind Pauly Mega, to send me out some of the modules for this machine so I can test out some cartridge gaming on it and compare and contrast it with the Analog Mega SG and the Analog Super NT that I currently own, which are both FPGA consoles. This is not an FPGA machine. It uses emulation. Everybody that is a detractor of Pauly Mega, and I understand that there are a lot of people that are against this whole philosophy, they would rather create their own emulation box and have their own control over how they play emulated games. This is a system, though, for collectors like myself that have sizable libraries of PlayStation 1, Sega CD, Sega Saturn, Neo Geo CD, and or TurboGrafx CD games. Now, I don't have Neo Geo CD games. I don't have TurboGrafx CD games. I actually asked my buddy Johnny Millennium at Happy Console Gamer to loan me a few of his TurboGrafx CD games, and I was able to play them beautifully on this machine. Holy crap, was that an incredible system, by the way. This was the year of me understanding how awesome the TurboGrafx 16 and the PC Engine is and was, and I've been able to play a ton of great TurboGrafx games. I have also been playing some of my Sega CD library, and it's interesting to play the full motion video games that was like this huge side genre that was happening because CD-ROM technology was becoming proliferate back in the day, and so everybody thought, hey, we could just shoot videos and we'll give people kind of choose their own adventure type of experiences. And it was kind of interesting technology, and certainly, you know, there are fantastic games that employ that kind of idea, like Dragon's Lair, but a lot of the Sega CD stuff, like Sewer Shark, and I played a Sega CD game made for the Sega CD 32X combo on the Pauly Mega called Fahrenheit, which was awful. It was terrible. The acting was terrible and the choices were lame, but there are a lot of sprite-based titles and a lot of early polygonal titles across the PlayStation and the Sega Saturn. I fell back in love with the Road Rash franchise, playing Road Rash 3D on the PlayStation 1, and then I've got, I think, Road Rash right here, which I have installed on the Pauly Mega as well. And that's a big deal with the Pauly Mega. That's an extra benefit to the Pauly Mega. You have an internal hard drive, about 8 gigs or something like that, and you can install a bunch of classic CD-ROM games onto that hard drive. You can also put in a micro SD card. You can also stick in your own SSD hard drive into the bottom of the Pauly Mega. It is incredible to be able to back up your library, because that's the thing. I have some very valuable software in here that you don't necessarily want to keep pulling out and playing right off of the disk. The Pauly Mega allows you to do that. You don't have to install anything. You can just run the games like you had a regular PlayStation 1 or a Sega Saturn hooked up or something like that, and they will run perfectly. But you can also back everything up. So I have this classic version of Astel, which was a really cool side-scrolling beat-em-up, and I wanted to install that. I checked out The Legend of Oasis on the Sega Saturn, and I was blown away by the graphics and sound of this game, so I installed that right to the hard drive, checked out Dune on the Sega CD. I've just been digging into all of this software again, and that's the thing for me. I've collected these games over multiple decades now, and they've stayed with me, and I haven't played them because I haven't wanted to deal with hooking up some of my classic machines and finding out ways to run them through up converters and stuff to hook them up to my 4K TV. I haven't wanted to dig out a CRT, and I don't have the space to have all of these different systems and stuff all hooked up everywhere. Maybe one day. But I really wanted some kind of a simple solution to allow me to re-experience some of this software and to find incredible surprises like Into the Hunt. You're looking at a lot of the footage that I've recorded recorded while I've been testing out software. Everything that I've thrown at the Polymega has worked quite well. I have noticed that there have been a little bit of shimmering issues on menu screens, like the front end is trying to lock into place, and I think that probably has something to do with the emulation upconverting to the resolutions that I have on my television. I am not Digital Foundry. I'm not going to be able to give you the reasons why things might look a little bit different. I don't know how everything stacks up one-to-one. I do know that you can attach patches to some of these classic games, some of them that will make a lot of these titles run a little bit better or have some different attributes to them. Generally, what I've been able to do with the Polymega is just run the games right off of my shelf and plug them into the machine and see them again. And some of them have been extraordinary delights, and some of them I've realized that I may not want to hold on to these games forever, but it has been this terrific experience for me to revisit the software and in most cases just recognize the extraordinary abilities of these game teams that were sometimes extraordinarily small and how inventive and creative they were, particularly when they were transitioning from 2D games on Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo and TurboGrafx to the 3D polygons, you know, and really understanding how to manipulate their characters and their spaceships and the things that they were building in three dimensions, and some of them to varying degrees of success. But it's been really, really valuable for me to enjoy that software again, and now I'm able to share it with you guys through streaming so easily. And that's why Polymega has really succeeded for me. This is a well-built little machine. It works exactly as advertised. I like all the front end. You get little blurbs and sort of recaps on what the software is, when it was created, a little breakdown on what the game is about, and maybe a little bit of insider information as well. And so with the modules that you'd be able to attach to this thing, you're going back to the NES and the Genesis and the Super Nintendo. And of course, there are a lot of hints that this is going to be a system that keeps on expanding and tries out different machines. Everybody's wondering about 3DO support or Atari Jaguar support. And I know that the founders of Polymega, because I had Brian Burnell on, the guy that actually had the full idea for this thing right at the get-go, have been trying to figure out just how far this is going to go. The online store hasn't launched. I'm still reviewing this hardware, which is, I think this is like beta 2, so it's not even finished, fully available on store shelves kind of hardware yet. But I wanted to come back and give you guys my thoughts on what this thing is like to live with and how successful this is as an enterprise. To kind of really let you know that I believe in this and I believe in what they're trying to do with this hardware. And I know that they are up against some huge challenges. Not only are we in the middle of a pandemic and they're trying to get all the manufacturing and everything done, and release dates have been slipping and pre-orders have been waiting. There are huge machines about to be launched with the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series S and X. So, you know, a lot of buzz is in a lot of different places, and the pressure has been on for Polymega. And this is an ambitious product. Holy crap, is it ambitious. The fact that you can, out of the box, plug in five different consoles worth of games, and people are expecting that they're all going to work, and they've been updating the software behind the scenes, the OS software behind the scenes. But honestly, everything's been working. The only time it didn't work for me is when I was trying to run a PC version of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 on this machine. I was streaming it, and I didn't have the PlayStation 1 version of the game, but I was like, why is this working in real time, which is incredibly embarrassing. And of course, I found the PlayStation 1 version of Tony 2, and it worked great on the system. That's the real joy of this. I would absolutely pick one of these things up if they weren't so kind to send me the review unit. I think it's one of the most exciting products of 2020, but I'm in their wheelhouse. You know, I have this collection, I have this library, and a lot of it's just been sitting for far too long. So I really love the Polymega. I can't wait to get the cartridge modules. I can't wait to talk with Brian Burnell some more about the future plans and sort of what's happening with launch and what's going on with this. But this has been and continues to be and will continue to be, because that's the cool thing, is now I've got this device that allows me to play some of this classic stuff and dive into it a little bit and share it with you guys in real time on live streams, which I've been having a blast with. So. Polymega for me so far has been a tremendous success. I hope everything goes smoothly with the launch. You know, I hope Final Hardware is as tuned and polished as everybody wants it to be. I hope everything is available, because getting orders to people in 2020 seems to have been and continues to be a big challenge for game companies out there. But Polymega is definitely a hit with me. I'm going to give my experience so far with Polymega a flat out 9 out of 10.